Good morning, everybody. Our project is audio-video classroom interaction on Akash. Then the agenda of our project is this presentation is that first we start with what is our project, audio-video classroom interaction on Akash, and then we go on by discussing what the technologies we have used, like HTML5, WebRTC, and then the Node.js and Socket.io. Then we carry on by discussing the functionalities of this project, the peer-to-peer video streaming between the instructor and the student, and then the audio doubts and the text doubts, and then the video broadcasting of the instructor to the students. And then we continue by discussing challenges faced and then the limitations of our project and the demonstration. Then first of all, what is audio video classroom interaction on Akash? The main backbone of our project is to enable a proper interaction between the instructor and the students. Usually in a traditional classroom scenario, what happens is the instructor comes and then he gives some lecture, and then the students, whoever has the doubt, has to stand in the class and has to ask the doubts to the instructor. Some of the students actually they feel shy to ask in the classroom, or some other reasons may be there, so that they may not ask the doubts. So what this application does is a student can directly ask his doubt to the instructor sitting in his own place using an Akash tablet. And also asking the doubt also have provided several means of communicating, and the main aim of this thing is to it can replace the user passage of the microphone to the students in order to ask doubts to the instructor. Without passing on the time delay can for passing on the microphone to the students can be avoided by using this thing. And then the technologies we have used are HTML5. This is a new technology, and then the WebRTC technology, this is also a very new technology which is a part of HTML5 itself. And then the Node.js, this is a server thing we have used additionally. And then the Socket.io, this thing we have used to for socket connections and all. And then the JSP servlet and Android also we have used. And then the technologies in detail, HTML5, the main reason we have used is using HTML5 we can develop the applications without use of any extra plugin. Example, for video streaming and all, for example for Skype we need to have some Skype plugin, but here we need not have any extra plugin to be installed. Direct communication can occur without any extra plugin. It's also easier to code for the programmers. Just for example, if you take this thing, exclamatory doc type HTML, by writing this thing in the first line itself, the browser will be able to understand that this is a HTML page. So many such sort of features are in HTML5, and also the new feature is that it has offline application cache. That means every application can have its own memory in the browser itself for every application. Next technology is the WebRTC. It is web real-time communication. This is an open source project which was started by Google and has been open sourced in 2011. And then what this technology does is it stores a built-in stack in the browser itself, and then whatever will be there, some extra, we need not store it in the actual system or somewhat, we can directly store it in the browser, some data. Then it uses just simple JavaScript to access these WebRTC APIs, so it's very easy to understand, also code it. Then the signaling process is given to the choice of the developer. In WebRTC, what happens is we can establish a direct peer-to-peer connection between the two systems, and then the interaction can go on directly between those two peers. In order for communicating between those two peers, the identification must be done. This peer must know that this peer is there, and this peer must know the addresses or the means of communication of this peer. For that purpose, we need some signaling process. What happens in signaling process is the IP and port of one peer will be transferred to the other peer, and that peer's IP and port will be transferred to the other peer, so that they can directly communicate between them after the signaling process. That choice has been given to the developer of the application itself in WebRTC. WebRTC doesn't specify any default signaling mechanism to be used. Then some of the examples are video calling, peer-to-peer file sharing, and etc. can be done using WebRTC. Next, WebRTC, it has mainly three APIs. The first thing is media stream API. Using this API, one can stream the video and audio between the two peers. It enables the direct streaming without any third-party plugins or anything. And then next one is RTC, peer connection API. Using this API, one can successfully establish a peer connection between two systems. And then next one is RTC data channel. Using this API, one can transfer any sort of text file or binary format, anything between two systems. These are the three main APIs in WebRTC. Coming to WebRTC architecture, initially all the web applications, they access, go through the web API, and through that they can access the WebRTC API directly in the browser itself. And then next we have the third one, there is session management or abstract signaling session. That thing is the actual signaling process between the two peers. Once that signaling process is done, then the two peers can directly communicate between them using these below things. In these three main features are that network I/O. Network I/O, what it does is, in order for these two peers to communicate, all the means of transfer, all that thing is taken care of by network I/O. Then these both are audio capture, render, and video capture. For capturing the video and streaming, such sort of purposes, these two things help. This is a brief architecture of WebRTC. Next, that we have used an extra server called node.js. This node.js server, what it does is we can code the server side coding in JavaScript. Actually, we use JavaScript for client side coding. We can use the JavaScript same in server side coding also using node.js server. Node.js server is event driven, non-blocking model. Event driven, whenever some event occurs, it does some action, the server. So it will not work throughout the application is run, but whenever some event occurs, then it responds to that thing. So there we can see the comparison of simple some Apache server and Node.js server. The horizontal x-axis is the number of requests and the y-axis is the response time. The above red color graph is the Apache server and below Node.js server, green one. We can see the response times of Node.js server is very lesser than compared to the Apache server. This is because main thing is Node.js is an event driven model. So that is why we can have very less response time. And then socket.io, for socket connections, and so we have used socket.io module. This can be integrated with the node.js server. We can use WebSockets or sockets or anything else, but we have used socket.io because socket.io doesn't have only one option. By default, it uses WebSockets for communication. And then if WebSockets, some browsers may not support WebSockets, the old browsers or somewhat. In such cases, socket.io bypasses WebSockets and uses some other alternatives like sockets or AJAX, long polling, etc. Such sort of techniques it uses. By default, the developer need not specify them. By default, uses WebSockets. In case of failure, it goes to some other alternatives. And then we have JSP and servlets also. Then Android we have used for developing the APK of on the student side. Next, these are the four steps that occur in video streaming in our application. The first thing is the local streaming. Here, all the student will have an Akash tablet, and the instructor may use an Akash tablet or a system also. That is depends upon the flexibility of the instructor, and then the student first he starts the local streaming on his tablet. He gets access to his permissions and then he allows them. And next step, what happens is the signaling process. First of all, for signaling process, the student will send offer to the instructor. Offer in sense SDP. SDP is session description protocol. It contains three parts: session description, time description, and media description. Session description contains about the session details of this particular peer, and then the time and media, both the media codecs, whatever the support is there, all that information will be passed, and then that will be received by the other peer. And then once that peer receives the offer from first peer, he responds to the offer in the form of an answer. In the answer, he also will send, second peer will send the same STP information of his own thing, his session, time and media also. After this thing, this is part is signaling process. And then what happens is, next, what happens to establish peer connection, some IP port, some sort of things must be there to directly communicate between two peers. So the student, one peer will send his ICE candidate. ICE is interactive connectivity establishment. To establish a connectivity, some IPs or ports and some other information must be there to communicate between them. This ICE candidates and indexes will be there. This will be sent to the instructor. This step is done once he receives the answer from the second peer only. Before receiving answer or offer, this will not happen. Once the offer is received, sent from there, and the answer is get back from there, then ICE candidates will be exchanged. ICE candidate will be sent there, and return also, the ICE candidate of that person will be sent to this person. Once this step is completed, then the two peers can directly communicate with them, between each other, without any intermediate thing. And now the connection is established, and then this video local streaming of the student can be directly streamed to the instructor without any Node.js server also we need not include in it. So direct communication, direct streaming can occur from browser to another browser. Browser of Android to desktop or anywhere. Android to desktop, Windows, Ubuntu, anywhere we can stream the video directly browser to browser. The functionalities of this project. There are mainly four functionalities. The first thing is live video streaming between the student and the instructor. And then this next is audio doubts. The student can post an audio doubt also to an instructor. And then he can also text the message. Also, one more option is that the broadcasting of video from the instructor to the student. First thing, peer-to-peer live video streaming. What happens in this module is the assumption we have considered is that every student will have an Akash tablet to use this application. And then when an instructor is present in the classroom, the student can ask a request to the professor. Just he will send, whenever student connects to the professor in his tablet, some information, the list of students will be displayed to the instructor. And then an instructor can select a student from the list of students who are asking the doubts. And whenever this instructor clicks on a particular student, then a particular peer connection will be established. And then this video will be streamed from the student to the instructor. And then the instructor can attend to the doubt and can answer the doubt open in the classroom. We may give the option of returning back through the application also, but we did not give it because if a student asks a doubt and then the instructor answers to a particular student only, then the other person also may have the same doubt. For that purpose, whenever a student asks a doubt, instructor will answer in open so that the doubts of other students also will be clear. Next, the audio and text doubts. This thing, the video doubts, that is possible only in a classroom. But it's not possible to answer, it's not possible for the instructor to answer the doubts of all the students in a single class. So for that purpose, we have created this audio and text doubts. A student can post these doubts to the particular instructor when the instructor is unavailable in the classroom also. So that the instructor can, when he was free, he can see those audio and text doubts and can answer to the students in the next class. Then the live broadcasting module. This thing, what happens is, some professor is delivering a lecture in one class. The other students in the other classes also may want to attend to that lecture, but the space is not sufficient. Using this broadcasting, the lecture in this classroom can be viewed to the other classrooms also. Broadcasting thing. And then the challenges that we have faced and the solutions we have found in developing this application is, first of all, choosing technology for video streaming. For video streaming, there are several other technologies. For example, in desktop browsers, we can directly use HTTP live streaming and do it. But in Android, Flash support is not there in Android 4.0 onwards. So we are not able to use that option. In this also, we have explored several options. We have come to a conclusion of using WebRTC. And then the search for WebRTC supporting browsers. Since WebRTC is a very new technology, it has been introduced over the 1 or 1.5 years back. It is still a work in progress. So that is why all the old browsers will not support it. So we have searched for the new browsers which will support it and have tested our sample codes in them to identify the browsers. And then the selection of server for signaling process. For signaling, we have searched and selected the Node.js server because it's an event-driven model. And then the multi-peer connections from a single browser. This problem we have encountered in video broadcasting. Individual peer-to-peer connections is okay, but from a single browser, multiple peer connections is somewhat difficult. This one we have overcome by using RTC multi-peer connection. And then the audio recording. For audio recording, new API, web audio API has to be supported in some browsers. It is supported in Chrome. We have found that and we have done it. Next, the limitations of our application are, first is the browser compatibility. From Chrome 23 and Firefox 22, from desktops it supports. All the browsers above those versions support this application, and then Chrome in Android, Chrome 27 and above will support. But one flag needs to be enabled, that is enable WebRTC in Android Chrome. In desktop, we need not enable any browsers, there are any flags. They are enabled by default. In Android itself, a single flag needs to be enabled. Next, the Web Audio API. This API is used when storing the audio doubts of the student. For this thing, Chrome 28 onwards it supports. Chrome 28 will be released in next 1 or 2 weeks. It was announced by Google. And Chrome 28 beta version has already come. It already supports this web audio API in Android. It supports in desktops, but in Android, the next release will support this audio API. And next, the multi-peer connection for broadcasting, we can have from a single browser, at most 10 peer connections are possible. More than 10 is not possible. These are the limitations of our project. Then the demonstration. This is the instructor module. This page is after the instructor logs in. Here, after the instructor logs in with his username and password, this is the home page which the student instructor can view. As we can see, there are some divisions: video requests, text doubts, send audio doubts, and broadcast. Initially, the instructor will be in video requests pane. In this first division, whatever the students will send requests, they will be listed in this section. We can see already one request has been sent from the tablet. Once the instructor clicks on that, chooses a person from the list of requests, the stream will be started. I've accessed from this tablet. Now they are connected and the student can ask his doubt to the professor. Whatever I'm speaking here, it will be transferred to their audio and video also. Now this video streaming, any number of tablets can be there. But at a time, connection will be between only two tablets, one tablet and. And then the switching also may occur. Whenever the instructor switches from one person to the other person, the previous one is, I am disconnected here. You can see here disconnected also. This student is disconnected, and then the next one, when he chose, that system tablet is connected. Whatever the doubt is asked there will be reflected over here. And the instructor can disconnect a particular student using the disconnect option. It will be disconnected and the request is gone. And next, the text doubts part. And then a student can text his doubt to the instructor. I am sending a text out now. I have sent the doubt and the question has been submitted. And then we can see that the third thing, that is what the doubt I have text to the instructor. And those are visible to the instructor. And the instructor can read those doubts and he can delete those doubts by using the done option. Once the instructor reads them, he can read them not only in the classroom when he is outside the classroom or anywhere, but the network connection is there. He can attend to those doubts and can answer them in the next class. The next thing is the saved audio doubts. This thing we have a limitation from the Akash tablets because the browser version is not yet released which supports this audio request in the tablet. In the next 2-3 weeks it will be released. It was announced by Google. We'll show the demo in the system itself. What we are trying is, instructor is in the system and the student is also in the system. For desktop browsers, it's working fine. For Android, the version is not yet released. So we'd like to show a demo on tablet system itself. This is the student. This is the student view. And then here, clicking here, this is the audio. By clicking here, we'll be redirected to the audio doubts pane. And then once the student clicks on start recording, then the permissions will be asked for microphone. Once the student clicks allow, and his doubt will be requested. What is WebRTC? And once the student asks his doubt, he can stop recording. And then he's also given an option of preview. Whenever he clicks preview, after listening to the sound, also after previewing his own doubt, he can click on forward. Once he clicks on forward, then the doubt will be submitted to the professor. You can see here the status has been uploaded, the file has been submitted successfully. And then in the instructor side, we can see
what components are there in WebRTC.
All the audio requests sent are listed over here to the instructor, and then the instructor can play them, listen to them, and answer in the classroom. And the other option, other feature we have is the broadcasting. And when this broadcasting can be initiated by the instructor only. Whenever the instructor clicks on broadcast, his stream will be viewed. And then when the student goes on to the broadcast view, a list of instructors who are online will be displayed to the instructor. And then a student can select from the list, any one person from the list. And then that stream will be broadcasted to the tablets, to all the students who are connected. The audio and video also can be transferred. And then the limitation of this thing is, up to now, whatever the WebRTC multi-peer connection API is there, it supports still 10 multi-connections. So 10 students can view this lecture, or else we can access from the system, and if an instructor gives his lecture in this room, some other 10 rooms can be connected and then connected to the projector.
Why is it necessary for the student to record the verbal question and then transmit? Can I not stream the question as the student speaks?
Audio doubts.
Audio.
Once when the instructor is present in the classroom, we are enabling the video request now.
The video automatically includes audio, is that what you are saying?
That is different and this is different module. First thing is, when the instructor is present in the classroom, direct the video and audio will be streamed from the student to the instructor.
Okay.
When the instructor is not present in the classroom,
You don't understand one thing. The requirement for this streaming, by the way, is different. The requirement is for recording every question that the student asks. The biggest problem in our large scaling of our education is when there are thousands of people, each individual person asking a question, that question has to be recorded and the answer has to be recorded. And that is where we need, we lose a whole lot of time in moving around the microphones and so on. So that was one of the reasons why. So therefore, we actually wanted to insert a microphone in the original clicker device. That was Professor Prakash Vaidya's idea. So that when you get up, if you are permitted to speak, you press a button and speak. So what you speak is actually streamed to the central station, which need not be a Akash or anything, and that is fed into the public address system. So if somebody, for example, I am holding this microphone and you are all listening to me because my voice is being streamed into those speakers. But if somebody from there asks a question, how does the class listen to that question? So that was the original intention, that you speak and the speech is fed into the thing as also recorded. Now, in your audio module, is that still possible? Because the way you have written it is only a pre-recorded content which is streamed. But there should not be any problem in streaming the speech as it is spoken, or there is a problem. That is happening, but what I would like to also have is that the video part is suppressed. Use the same module, but use it only to stream audio. Alternately, if the bandwidth is good enough, if the connection is good enough, you can stream both audio and video, and the audio stream can be separated out and fed it to the public address system. Anyway, extremely good work. This has been a pending work in progress for almost 2 years. We have given it up. But please understand that when we conduct training program for 10,000 teachers and there are 30 teachers in Coimbatore and one teacher wants to ask a question, the interaction time is extremely limited because everybody in the country is watching what is going on, and almost minute and a half is lost in just taking a microphone to that teacher, and 50% of the time that microphone does not work. So this would be a great operational time saver for people if it works. So you are confident that this system will work? Can I try it in actual field in this December when I conduct the 10,000 teachers workshop?
Yes, sir.
So if some teachers in the country cannot hear or cannot see, then I'll send them to you. Anyway, my compliments, personal thanks. Very good work. Let's give them a big hand.